Three of the men who were exonerated in 2010 were Bobby Ray Dixon, Larry Ruffin, and Philip Bivens. All three were convicted in 1980 of a brutal rape and murder in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Innocence Project New Orleans won DNA testing in the case in 2010. The testing showed that none of the men were involved and that the crime had been committed by a man who was later convicted of a similar crime in the area. Bobby Ray Dixon and Philip Bivens were released in September 2010 after 30 years in prison. Their co-defendant, Larry Ruffin, had died in prison 8 years before. 6 weeks after his release, Bobby Ray Dixon died of cancer. Philip Bivens now lives in New Orleans.
I never thought I'd be arrested for something I didn't do. I really didn't think anything like this would ever happen to me. The DNA came back, and I said, whew. I just went to thinking, you know, and man. I said, man, I thought it would never happen, you know, because I tried, you know, all the, you know, contacting people, lawyers and stuff like that. And after about 20 years, I'd almost got to the point where I gave up. I figured there wasn't no way. Things had changed so much that I'm going off back off into a world I knew nothing about.
The inspiration for IPNO was a simple statistic that there were over 4,000 prisoners in Louisiana State Penitentiary up at Angola serving sentences of life without parole, and none of them had a right to a lawyer to help them with their post-conviction appeals, not one. And some of them, inevitably, would be innocent.
Innocence Project New Orleans represents prisoners in Louisiana and Mississippi who are sentenced to life without parole or significant terms of years, who have cognizable claims of factual innocence. A conservative estimate of the rate of innocent people in prison in the United States is 3.3%. So if 3.3% of the state's lifers in Louisiana are innocent, there are approximately 140 innocent people in Louisiana serving life without parole.
With a life sentence, you're not entitled to a lawyer. After your direct appeal, you're basically on your own. But then a lady named Emily Bolton established the Innocence Project for New Orleans. Why in Angola you going up against impossible odds? You don't have the documents to prove anything that you think that took place in your case. You don't have the outside help. The only resource is to try to get the help of some innocent project. That's the only hope that they have in getting out. They don't have nobody. And I know a few guys that actually died in prison that I knew that they was innocent.
We've had a system which generally had not been as perfect as we'd like. Human beings and their frailties and a horrible prejudice against defendants charged with serious and horrendous crimes is just two strikes against the accused in most instances.
When you actually meet a client, you begin to realize that numbers like 23 years or 15 years are more than just years. You know, there are 365 days to a year. You begin to realize that a falsely imprisoned man is spending every minute of every hour of every day in a prison, and it's something that a lot of folks, including myself, choose not to think about. There are tens, if not hundreds, of individuals who are wrongfully incarcerated in Louisiana prisons, and as long as we know that that's a fact, and all the empirical evidence shows it is, and our experience shows it is, then we need to work as hard as we can to get those individuals out.
We could really not ask for better visionaries on the ground and collaborators on our cases than Emily and the rest of the crew there who have really just done such incredible work over the past decade.
The Innocence Project is more than just a safety net. IPNO has shown us weaknesses in our criminal justice system.
It's made the system a little more honest, whether from the police to the prosecutors to the judges to the appellate review staff. it's extremely important that what they have done has contributed to helping the system.
Since Innocence Project New Orleans began, we have freed 18 men from prison on the basis of innocence and cleared the name of one man who died in prison after serving 23 years for a crime he didn't commit. In New Orleans, we authored a $1.4 million grant for agencies around the city to work together to clean up the evidence facilities. So far, this project has inventoried over 15,000 pieces of evidence in New Orleans that were simply not documented before we got involved.
The Innocence Project does more than just find and help correct past problems. It works very hard to prevent future problems.
Innocence Project New Orleans could not have accomplished what it has to date without the help of hundreds of volunteers over the years. We simply couldn't do our job were it not for law students who donate hundreds of hours and volunteer lawyers from the community. We would not have got where we are today without the generosity of bar foundations and private lawyers and other members of the community who very, very generously give of their money as well as their time to help us get innocent men out of prison and advance reforms that will prevent the innocent from being convicted in the future.
On behalf of the clients whose cases began when IPNO began, to the people here tonight who paid the bills in those early years, thank you. Look into their eyes in these pictures of our clients at the moment of their release and know that you've put the gleam there. At the heart of the project were and always will be the prisoners we represent. With generous cooperation from the warden and his legal programs team, it was the prisoners at Angola who got the word out that IPNO was up and running. It was the jailhouse lawyers called Inmate Counsel who helped distribute the application forms around the prison into the furthest corners, explaining the criteria and assisting with filling in the forms.
After I retired from the bench, I chose to be a member of the board because in my experiences I knew, perhaps as well as anybody, about the frailties within the system, the failures within the system as well. I think not just the legal community, but people with any kind of heart and mind should support, financially and otherwise, those who work in this vineyard, in my opinion. There are innocent people in jail, maybe a very small minority, but every innocence, it's a horrible injustice for that to occur. And we've had a system which generally has not been as perfect as we'd like, if I may say that. And people have in jail who are innocent have virtually no hope and no opportunity to get representation unless it is by such a group as the Innocence Project of New Orleans.
The Innocence Project is important because if you take every dollar that the Innocence Project ever spent, if you take every man hour that any one person's ever put in while they work on the Innocence Project, and if they got one person off that didn't belong there, it'd be worth it. I am really excited, probably more so than anything else, at the growth of the Innocence Project.
What IPNO is doing is really undoing years of unfairness. Every lawyer, whether they're a prosecutor or a defense attorney or a civil lawyer, should be happy that we have the safety net that IPNO is now providing us with.
The opportunity to co-counsel a case with the Innocence Project was extremely eye-opening. And I found myself throughout the many years I was involved in the Anthony Johnson case thinking at night about where he was. The issues that we found that caused the wrongful conviction of Mr. Johnson are present and exist today. Being a board member at the Innocence Project is very much an honor.
Innocence Project New Orleans received enormous support and will always be grateful for Kathleen Hawk Norman. Kathleen was the chair of our board of directors from 2004 until she died in 2009. She was called to serve as a juror in 1994 in Orleans Parish. She served as the foreperson of the jury that convicted a man of first degree murder and sentenced him to die. When Kathleen learned a long time after this man was convicted, that the prosecution had withheld FBI reports showing that he was not the man responsible for the murder, she really became angry. She supported us through all sorts of ups and downs. We will always be grateful for what Kathleen did for Innocence Project and for the spirit that she brought that lives on in the work we do now.
You can say you've been born again. You know, it was joyful. The world know now. You understand that we didn't commit that. Being wrongfully accused of something you didn't do about. You know, it's hurt, you know, and it damaged you in a way. So that healed it. That really healed it.
I'm enjoying my freedom, and I try to enjoy my freedom every day that I wake up. Every day.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Ooh, yeah.
Alan, did you guys storm New Orleans, Louisiana? But you made Innocence possible in Mississippi, and we are really grateful to you.
Hey, Ipno, how's your moms and them? We love you. You guys are kick-ass.